Hey, greetings and salutations. Well, yesterday working on the dually, I broke my microphone mount. Can't use this today. It's windy again today, so before I step foot out of the garage and you're just inundated with all sorts of wind noise, I want to tell you what I'm up to today. I'm going to attempt to run some gas line to where the fuel cell is going to reside and get that hooked up to the generator. I have this small electric fuel pump. I need to put that in someplace near the fuel cell because it's easier to push fuel than it is to pull fuel. And then I got to run hard line from the fuel cell over the basement and into the generator compartment. That's the word I'm looking for. Might be a little bit windy, but it's a beautiful day today.
Let's see if I can drill a hole. This is a piece of foam. Yeah, let's see about that. Oh, there's my fuel pump.
My bad.
How rude.
Nasty.
Okay, there's no indication of what direction this pumps. So I'm gonna assume that it pumps this way, but you should never assume. If you assume, you make an ass out of you and me. So never assume, always verify. An RC battery. I will eventually get some isolators to isolate this from the chassis, but for right now I'm just running the stuff, man.
Let's see if I have one. An AN fitting. Let's see here. This looks like 3/8. In my fitting jump drawer, another fuel pump. What's this? Ah, there's one right there. If you've never seen one of these before, this is a compression fitting. It comes with a ferrule. A compression fitting to AN. This is number 6 AN. And you just hook this end up to a hard line. These are for fuel systems. That's what they're made for. And they generally offer them in 5/16. And 3/8. I'll put a link in the description for some of these AN fittings. And we'll, yeah, that's an Earl's fitting. So, link in the description. Go check it out. Some of you might think I'm a sellout. Perhaps I am, but I'm trying to make a little bit of money here so that I can pay for some of these projects, right?
And one of the ways I do that is through ad revenue on YouTube. And one of the ways you can help is by letting those ads play, even though you can click them off. And if you see anything that's in your wheelhouse, click on those ads, man. Go to them. I get paid based on those clicks, man. Just help a brother out. And another way that you can help support this channel financially is to check the description for affiliate links to Amazon. Many of you shop at Amazon. And if you see something like fittings, and you're in the market for some fittings, go click on that link in the description. And if it's not the fitting that you're looking for, just go ahead and, you know, click to that link and then go through that link to whatever it is you're shopping for. And the channel earns a little bit of a commission. I make a couple of pennies on those purchases, and believe me when I tell you, those pennies mean the world to me, man. Help a brother out, eh? I gotta go put this battery on a charger. And if you need a GoPro battery, check the link in the description. They're there. Oh, shut up.
Hello. So let me show you how to put this little fitting together. Put this on first, right? And then put the ferrule on. Right? Then you put the fitting on, bottom the fitting up, push this all the way into the bottom of the fitting, and then simply tighten this up. Yay. Come on, let's go.
Need to make a battery cable, hook this solenoid up, and I'm going to hook this battery cable to the positive lug on the starter. All right, so the fuel line's hooked up from the fuel cell to the generator. I eventually put an inline filter between the fuel cell and the fuel pump, but for right now I'm going to have to do without. So right now I need to make a cable to run from the positive post on the starter of the bus engine to the start solenoid inside the generator cabinet. And to do that, I need to get these terminal ends crimped down to this cable here. There's a couple ways you can do that. You could fill this with solder and solder them on. That's one way to do it. Another way would be to take this laying on the bench and just beat it flat. But the better way is to get one of these. This is a battery terminal crimper. This one's pretty inexpensive. This one's like 20 bucks. I got this on Amazon. I think I got it on Amazon. I'll look for one on Amazon. And if I can find one, check the link. They like to take and grind this bevel off so that when you put the shrink wrap on, there's not a lump there. Hold on, I'll be right back. But you see I ground that little flare off of there. So I'm going to push it on there, and I'm going to lay it on here, and I'm going to whack it with this hammer. But first I'm going to move my camera so I don't jar the piss out of you guys. All right. So. And just like that, she's crimped on. shrink wrap on, put the heat gun out, shrink it down, Bob your uncle. Do the same thing to the other end. Yeah. See? There. How's that? You saw me test that fuel pump, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of these RC batteries, and I've made up a little pigtail, plug that into the fuel pump, plug this into there, put a little bit of gasoline inside that fuel cell, or maybe I'll just take that and run a hose into, that's probably what I'll end up doing, just run a hose into this gas can before I put fuel in that fuel cell. And make sure that it's actually going to deliver fuel and run with that fuel pump on there.
All right. This particular pump running right now is a 3-pit, 3 to 7 PSI. And that one is a 1.5 to 3. And it wouldn't run on the small one. Let's see here. Let me try something else. Hold on. All right, I bypassed that one altogether, directly into the freaking fuel tank with this 5.5 to 9 PSI pump. Let's see if the generator's needle valve can handle that kind of pressure. Oh, that sounds so much better. Yeah. Exactly whisper quiet.
Well, that's less than ideal. Let's do this.
Yahtzee.
So the small one will not work, but this one, I think this one might be a little bit too much. This is a 12 volt 5.5 to 9 psi. I'm not sure if I need 5.5 to 9 psi. I figured that I have to check to see what that one is. I think that one is maxes out at 4, and it wasn't enough to make this thing run. So we'll see. I'll do a little more research, but at this point, I need to hook up some sort of a kill switch because that one ain't working. I need to track out why. I want to be able to shut it off from inside the bus. And start it from inside the bus if I can. If not, I'll just start it out here. Ain't a big deal. I ain't scared. So if you like the fact that I'm the king of jerry rig, smash that like button. If you think that I'm foolish and I'm a hazard to everyone around me, click the dislike button twice. Honestly though, guys, I would appreciate it immensely if you would like this video, smash that like button and share it. That does a couple of things. It makes me feel good about me, and it tells the artificial intelligence over there to Google that people are actually engaging in these videos. And if you like and share, then YouTube is more likely to recommend these videos in other people's feeds. Look, we're all interconnected, man. It's like, if you like this stuff, you probably know people that would like this stuff. And if you like and share, it just keeps paying it forward, and YouTube says, oh, people like this guy's garbage. Let's recommend it to other people. Apparently YouTube's not doing that very much anymore. Like and share, I would appreciate that immensely. It helps the channel a lot. Products that you see in these videos, anything you might be interested in regarding the topic or possibly the equipment that I use to shoot these videos, there's Amazon links in the description. And even if you don't want any of that stuff and you're gonna shop on Google anyway, why don't you do me a huge favor and just go through one of those links. You don't have to buy it. You just click on that link, go. I don't know what that's for. And go get, I don't know, a cat toy I don't know, whatever it is that you're looking for. Maybe coffee filters, I don't know. It doesn't cost you anything extra to buy your stuff on Amazon. Just the channel gets a little bit of a commission, pennies, but every penny counts. These things ain't cheap, man. And believe me when I tell you, I need all the help I can get. That's all I got today. I'm running out of time as usual. I got my fuel system from a generator. The generator's running. The only thing I didn't do is plug it in and test it. I'll do that tomorrow morning. So tomorrow's dart day. I'll be working on the dart tomorrow. Well, actually it'll be tomorrow for me. It'll be probably Friday for you, or Thursday. What's tomorrow? Wednesday. Yeah, it'll be Thursday for you. Anyway, it'll be the next video. It'll be on the dart. I know it's been a minute, right? Until then, you have fun, stay safe, shoot straight, keep the powder dry, and have a splendid day. All right, put this away. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.